As authorities try to clamp down on the spread of new COVID cases, testing has hit record heights in South Australia. But tonight there are calls for greater measures, including masks to be worn by all passengers on public transport, prompted by concerning images of crowded trains.
Packed into a train carriage, passengers on board the Seaford line aren't the only ones struggling to stay socially distanced on public transport.
Footy Express has been extremely difficult and we're seeing full standing loads.
Prompting calls for all passengers to wear protective face masks on their commute.
Face mask wearing on public transport will help limit the potential spread of COVID-19.
But the Premier says that isn't the current health advice. Today, joining the Health Minister at the Royal Adelaide Hospital to spruik a new machine called the Panther. The state-of-the-art technology helping boost SA's COVID-19 testing capabilities.
We'll increase the capacity by a further 800 tests over a 16-hour shift.
After a record 6,000 tests yesterday, South Australians were today getting swabbed at a new drive-through clinic at Aldinga, and testing was in overdrive at Victoria Park for a second day in a row.
Of the 6,000 tests taken across the state yesterday, 900 of those were taken at the Victoria Park site.
Amid calls for mandatory medi-hotel quarantine for people returning from Victoria, the Hotels Association says communication is key to managing it effectively.
This is a dangerous virus. And we've got to make sure that the self-isolation is exactly that. People are isolated for 14 days.
While the Premier has ruled out making it mandatory at this stage, he says that could change as they assess the worrying situation interstate. Further restrictions will also be considered when the Transition Committee meets tomorrow. Kate Lamb, Nine News.
600 guests are tonight making their way into Adelaide Oval for a South Australian Liberal Party function, despite the government reintroducing COVID restrictions this week, capping the number of people allowed at weddings, funerals and private homes. An events business owner who's had to cancel bookings says the Liberal Women's Council dinner flies in the face of new rules.
We've had to cease trading again over 3 months into this whole COVID situation with these new restrictions, but the government can go ahead with a dinner indoors for 600 people.
And if you're reimposing restrictions on funerals and weddings, it does seem a little unusual to be proceeding with a political dinner for hundreds of people.
Georgia Westgarth is at Adelaide Oval, and Georgia, the Premier is defending the event.
He is, Brendan. Ministers we've spoken to today say all coronavirus restrictions must be met. New rules came into effect yesterday, limiting the number of people that can attend a household gathering. Pubs and restaurants can now also only serve people while they're seated, and there are still limits on funerals and weddings. But event organisers say the function will comply with all current restrictions, which includes the 2 square metre rule.
All events, whatever the venue, have to comply with the rules, and that's a matter for the event organisers.
It's a very different event from a wedding or a dancing type event. So people are spaced out. I think it's important that we get on with whether it's a business or a political event, but they've got to conform to the very strict COVID-19 requirements.
And Brenton, this function has sparked infighting within the Liberal Party. Not all party members are supportive of it going ahead.
All right, Georgia, thank you.